Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Public Allies. I'm your host for today's business promotion, and my name is Aisha Sardar. At Public Allies, although we are trying to help the most vulnerable, at the same time, during this pandemic, we have taken upon us to help the businesses too, especially the local businesses. And one such local business that we came across is Memory Bloom. And the founder of Memory Bloom, Doreen Fernandez, is here with us today. So let me introduce Doreen to all of you. Doreen is, after many years working in financial industry, she decided to pursue her passion for writing, specifically legacy writing. However, her love for writing takes her down many paths, but she loves to do legacy writing. She learned a lot in the corporate sector, and that is the that knowledge she wants to apply and assist other businesses also with presentations and documentations. As a legacy writer, she loves to create keepsakes for families to cherish and hand them down through the generations. She truly believes that it is a priceless gift. Doreen, welcome to our platform. And I know I messed it up a little in your bio. If you want to clear it up, please go ahead. It happens sometimes.
No, you were perfect. Thank you so much, Aisha, for giving me this opportunity. I'm just so thankful to you and Public Allies for what you're doing in the community and helping small business owners like myself to be noticed out there for what we're trying to do. So thank you so much for that introduction.
Oh, that is our pleasure that we can be of help. Okay, tell us a little bit about Memory Bloom and how it started.
So I worked, as you said in the intro, in the financial services sector for over 20 years. And I stumbled upon my passion, you know, being a wife and a mother and, you know, looking after the household. You typically don't tend to look at what you like to do. And as circumstances would have it, during a role redundancy at the bank that I worked at, I started to really think about, you know, who I am and what I wanted to do for me. The time was right. You know, my kids were now older, and I realized that I love to write. And I didn't realize how and where and who I was going to write about or where it was going to go. But I just started writing little things and posting them on Facebook. Mm-hmm. And somebody who I worked with about 15 years ago saw this and reached out to me and asked me to write her mother's story. It really blew me away because I had not even considered doing something like that. And I thought, sure, I'll take on the project. And I did. And after speaking with her father, who had lost his wife, I put the story together, and it turned out to be such a beautiful project. You know, I got to know this woman who had passed away, but was such an admirable woman. She went through so many challenges and she was a fighter. And I created a book and created about 25 copies for their family and friends. And when they saw the book and read the book and saw the photos in there from her from childhood up until she passed away, they thanked me for what I had done. And I had no idea that the impact that I would have on this family would be so meaningful. And that's what led me down the path to pursue legacy writing and story writing. As you can see behind me on the shelf there, I've got a few books that I've done for people and albums and memory boxes. So I do quite a bit of different services and products for legacy writing. I really do believe it is a priceless gift. It's not something that you just go to the store and buy. You know, it's something meaningful to the family to have that as a keepsake and a treasure to remember somebody forever. It never gets lost. And to have that book, sitting on a coffee table and not buried, memorabilia sometimes gets buried in boxes and put away in storage and never comes out. But this is a really beautiful way to keep that person's memory alive and visible every day. And of course, working in the corporate sector, I learned so much working in that area that I'm able to apply my writing services to help various businesses with their writing needs.
Yeah, absolutely. So you absolutely believe that memory lives forever.
Absolutely, it does. Yes.
So, and it is better than any other gift.
Right. For me, it is. For me, it's you know, I love to see the look on my client's face, mm-hmm. you know, when they receive the book that I've done finally, and they're holding it in their hands. You know, they get very emotional, you know, to have somebody's life almost held in their hands. You know, the journey, the trials, the triumphs. It's and to have it shared with your children and grandchildren. Sometimes we don't know what our parents or our grandparents really went through, what they sacrificed, and reading about them is just, it defines who we are. I really do believe that.
Yeah. So it is not a book that, you know, you're making it for the bookstores or you're writing it so you can promote yourself. It is specifically a gift to pass on the knowledge from one generation to the next. If you have not met your grandparents, if you have not met somebody, this is the book that will tell you more about them.
Yes, it is. It's private to the family, you know, when it means something to the family. So it's not for public consumption unless the family wants to share it with the public to read it. But, mm-hmm. you know, it's the innermost private thoughts and feelings of a person. And somehow people open up to me because I'm a stranger. And they don't tend to speak with their children or close loved ones about their feelings, but me as an outsider, they open up to me and they tell me all about themselves, you know, and it just amazes me. And sometimes they find it very therapeutic to unburden their soul, mm-hmm. You know, and I'm very respectful of my clients' time and their what they share with me. I always consult with them as to what they want included in the book and what they want left out of the book, just so that, you know, that they feel proud to hand that over to someone else to read.
Okay, this makes me very curious. So sorry if I'm asking too many questions.
No.
But has it ever happened that, you know, if you're writing a book about the parents, the kids didn't know something about them? Can you, like, is it okay if you can share one of those instances with us?
Absolutely. I mean, a lot of times the children don't know about their parents and how they felt. You know, it's for one of my clients who I wrote a book about, this gentleman was born in Poland. Mm-hmm. And at the age of 5, he was shipped to a concentration camp in Russia.
Wow.
Yes, it was a very sad story, you know, as great as his memory was, it wasn't good memories, you know, mm-hmm. but how he handled life and what he built for himself after his challenges. I mean, from Russia, he was shipped off to India and separated from his family. And then at the age of 15, found his way to Canada somehow, worked so hard, and he never let any of the hardships bring him down. He fought to make a life for his children and his grandchildren when they came along. He met the love of his life. You know, he talked very intimately about his wife and his love for his wife. Oh. And those are things that you don't really share with your children. So yes, when his children and grandchildren read the book, they were astonished as to how he really felt about his wife and how he felt about life and how he approached life. Those are things that, you know, they didn't see in their grandpa, because when they saw their grandpa, it was always fun grandpa who was there to play with them or help them. But they didn't realize the pain and suffering, as well as the joy he experienced in his life.
So did they know about the camp itself, or they didn't?
They knew a little bit about it, but they didn't know the details about, you know, him not having food to eat, or him, you know, watching his mother pass away in the camp, you know, things like that, that he kept hidden inside of him until I met him and we kind of, you know, wrote the story, and it really was very impactful.
Yeah, like, it's so touching. The story is so touching. I feel it's so, like, close to me. I can only imagine how his grandkids or his kids feel about it, right?
Yeah.
And they have a book now to look back.
Exactly. And, you know, sadly and unfortunately, he passed away January of this year. And his son and his wife called me to tell me about the news. And, you know, this is the other thing that happens with me, because I spend so much time with them in their homes, in their kitchen, learning about them and writing their story. I become part of their family. You know, they trust me. They trust me to come in there and respect them and take their story and write it. And when he passed away, his son called me to say, I'm so glad we did this when we did, so that I was able to get that story done. I was just so thankful that I was given that opportunity, as I found it as a gift for me, because I learned so much from the person. I learn about strength. I learn about resilience. I learn about helping and coping. So I get a lot out of it for myself as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And we love what you're doing. So we want more people to know about it. But as we come to the end, we want to keep it short. So tell us, what else do you do other than legacy writing?
So because of the COVID pandemic, you know, I wasn't able to meet a lot of people because of social distancing. So I turned my, my sights into what else can I do? And because I have such a vast, years and years of experience in the corporate sector, I thought, let me write for businesses, because businesses need help. And that's where I kind of focus my attention, is on helping businesses, whether it's website content, blog articles, newsletters, process documentation. So I'm able to apply a lot of what I learned in my career to helping businesses with their needs. So I joined an amazing group, and I want to give them a huge shout out, because they're a big part of me and my life, and I'm so grateful to them. It's Connecting GTA under the leadership of Suresh Kumar. We are a networking group of businesses and entrepreneurs, and I've been helping a lot of the members in that club with their writing needs and helping them out.
Yeah. So yeah, we find so many groups. There have been a lot of groups which have helped businesses in networking, helping each other out, and giving them tips and tricks, and bringing the live events, live networking events, into the online and virtual setup. So I want to applaud each and every one of those networking groups for doing that. And that's why even Public Allies is on the social media now. So we want to thank you for spending this time with us and promoting your business. We hope it works. And anybody listening there, if you want to promote your business, please feel free to connect with us. Leave a message or a comment on this video, or send us a personal message. Connect with Neil Padmanabhan, who is our director for engagement, or even Doreen, she will connect you to us. So yes. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful evening. Thank you, Doreen.
Thank you, Aisha. And if anybody wants to reach me and has questions, you can reach me at my website, which is memorybloom.ca, and my contact information is on there. I thank you from the bottom of my heart, Aisha, for this opportunity this evening. Yeah. I respect you and what you're doing for our community of business owners. I'm sure you're going to get a lot of notice and for what you're doing to raise visibility. And congratulations on winning the Civic Award. I know that you've worked very hard, and you deserve all that honor and praise. So I look forward to growing with your organization. And if there's anybody that I can help, I'm very happy to. So thank you again very much.
Yeah. Thank you for being with us tonight. And everybody have a good day, good evening, and we will see you soon. That is on Thursday with yet another webinar. Take care. Bye.
Thank you.